on the flip side of the deal, what are the Cavs going to look like with Isaiah Thomas and Jae Crowder lining up with LeBron James?
So this is really fascinating. What they needed against Golden State was more players who could defend multiple positions, more guys they could throw at Kevin Durant. Obviously, you're never going to stop Kevin Durant. You might not ever slow him down, but just somebody you can put in his way and can say, look, just play really hard. Do what you can. We'll hope for the best here. Somebody who wasn't LeBron, because LeBron has so many offensive responsibilities. They need him to be able to play that sort of free safety role, and they got that in Crowder. The thing is, their point guard defense actually got worse. You know, Irving can defend when he decides he wants to. Thomas gives all he can at all the time on defense, and he dies on screens. But he just can't. He's just physically unable to defend a lot of guys. If you screen him off a guy, he's too small to recover and defend at all. So that becomes a real issue. Their guard defense is a disaster. Derrick Rose, Isaiah Thomas, Jose Calderon, that's their point guard rotation. They have no defensive answers there. They're going to have to be hiding someone at all times, and the Warriors are built so that you're not able to hide anyone. So I think adding Crowder is huge for them. Obviously, Thomas is a great player. He'll be their starting point guard. He'll do really well next to LeBron offensively, but defensively, they're still in real trouble. I don't think this puts them anywhere near the Warriors, barring a huge series from LeBron. And you know, obviously he can do that, but that's a big question mark.
You know who sounds like a great matchup to play against the Cavs right now?
Who's that?
Kyrie Irving.
Kyrie Irving is going to have a lot of points against the Cleveland Cavaliers.
All right.